Hi, I'm Lisa Chandler. I play Mother Camera in the newly anticipated Long Legs film directed by Oz Perkins. And you are watching Pop Culture with Pat. You can also watch me in the new MGM Plus show, Billy the Kid, playing Susan McSween.
What's your favorite scary movie?
Hey guys, welcome back to Pop Culture with Pat. So I am so excited to be joined by today's guests. Today we are going to be talking all things Long Legs with Mother Camera herself, Lisa Chandler. Thank you so much for coming on the show today.
Thanks for having me. This is great. Thanks, Pat.
You're very welcome. Yeah, I'm so excited to talk to you about, the film and in your career. First off, to start things off, congratulations on the film this weekend. It did was like 23 million or something like that
Yeah, around
domestic.
that.
It broke box office records for Neon and
Yeah, it was just under Despicable Me 9 or whatever number they're at, but
I love that the marketing that they put out too. It was like number one besides
I
Despicable Me
know,
4.
right? They did a really good job with that. Like I don't know, they played with it, which I thought was brilliant.
Oh yeah, whoever was like in charge of the marketing just for this film overall, they definitely deserve a pay raise because probably some of
Need
the
to
best
teach
marketing that
this
I've
in
seen.
school because it has been phenomenal marketing. Even like the phone number that you call with Nick,
Yep.
on the back, even there was even people who tagged one of the posts or one of the billboards in LA, and I saw, I think it was on Fairfax or Wilshire. Anyways, they tagged the bottom, but they left the date.
Yep.
So like taggers like graffiti tag. It was, and that obviously has nothing to do with the film, but I'm just like, there's a little bit of respect there, which was, I thought was kind of
So
hilarious.
good. Yeah, I mean,
Very good.
I think like a good indicator too. So I seen the film twice. I saw it Thursday opening night, and then I saw it again. Was it Saturday night? I think it was. And
Okay.
saw it Thursday night. And so I'm in New Hampshire, and I feel like when new horror movies comes out, there's usually like a good amount of people. Like it's usually not like sold out or anything. I went Thursday night, basically a sold out theater, like minus like maybe like the front row where it's like you're gonna be like looking up at like the screen. And then saw it again Saturday and basically sold out theater, like the exact same theater that I went to. And they actually added on showtimes for the movie because like it was doing, so well. So I was like, wow, there's definitely something going on here.
Yeah, my brother, he's in Kuala Lumpur right now, and he said that there was a poster for it. He was excited to see, go over there. He works overseas, obviously, and in China there and in the surrounding area, but he was stoked to see the poster, and then it was also going to be in English. So when he saw it, he was like, it was pretty full over there.
Yeah.
And it was really cool to see worldwide,
Yeah,
the
it's
hype,
so cool.
and people going back into the movie theater and filling their
Yep.
bums with seats, it's great. I love it. I have a
Yeah.
friend that went Saturday night and they reserved their seats. There's three of them. They reserved their seats and every single seat was full. Handicap, all the stalls to put the wheelchairs in, completely full.
Oh, wow.
All the aisle seats where they're like not the greatest, up in the top corner where you're kind of on an angle, full. Everything was full. And I was like, I love that. That's
It's
awesome. It's great.
so cool. Yeah, I mean like horror is like probably like my favorite genre like overall. So anytime you see a horror film like this, especially like a smaller like budget one to do this well, it's just such a cool thing to see marketing movement that, this thing had between this and then like another film that's say not so much horror, but I was a big fan of like Inside Out 2 and just
Oh
seeing
yeah.
one that thing has been on for,
Yes.
for the past like several like weeks as well. So just being a big film fan in general, seeing movies like this doing so well just makes me really happy.
Yeah, I'm pretty pumped for it. It's I'm pumped for it because I'm part of it. You know what I mean? And
Yeah.
we're just making it, at the time we were just making a small film. It wasn't like this huge studio film, nothing like that. So it's really cool to see Oz's concept. Film it on a budget, film it on certain locations that we only had access to, film it in weather conditions that were a bit challenging sometimes, and then have them edit it, have them do all the post stuff, have them do everything else, and then have this, release of it and have this like wave of people being like, what is this?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool to be a part of it. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, I can imagine. Just like sitting there and having to not say anything for the longest time too, because we talked about the marketing being so great, but just how secretive it was at first too, like the trailers, the way that they were done, that I was like, what is this movie? Because I initially I didn't know what it was about or anything, and just the little teases here and there, I think really helped with that wave that you were talking about.
Yeah, and they did a full feature trailer, but they didn't show you the movie, which I
Yeah.
love. I just saw three trailers on the TV the other day. I'm like, well, saw the film. Bye. I'm not gonna watch
Yeah.
it. But this, they did, they cut it so well. They just showed snippets, but still showed a full length trailer where you leave like, what is it about? What's you're trying to put the pieces together, which
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it's brilliant
Which I think
being
is
able
appropriate for this kind of movie, like putting the pieces
to.
together. But yeah, before we dive into it any further, guys, I just want to give you guys a heads up that this interview will contain some spoilers. So if you haven't watched the movie yet, what are you doing? Make sure you go check it out, and then come back and watch the rest of this interview. But actually, just to kind of to start things off for you too, Lisa, I also just want to ask you, where did your love from film kind of come from in the first place? And you have a large background in stunts. How did you kind of get started in that initially?
I was always kind of a tomboy, sporty person growing up. I've always loved theater, so I kind of blended the two. When I was a kid, doing plays here and there as much as I could, living in small towns, and then did background work, did stand-in work, trying to make, a career when you're like in your 20s of auditioning. And then I was also playing hockey out in Toronto, so I was trying to blend the two. It didn't. Time-wise and money-wise, didn't pan out as I thought. So I kind of hung up the laces and then just did acting, and then discovered stunts like later on. I had no idea about stunts, and then I was working on a film. I was doing stand-in work. Saw the stunt department in the corner, and I was like, "That's pretty cool. I like that. That's badass." And so I just kind of worked my way socially and training-wise into the community, and just. Did one after another after another after another, and just kept training and training. And then just I wouldn't say put acting on pause, but I just really did the stunts full tilt for like 10 years while bringing in the odd acting role here and there, and then realizing that there's a thing called stunt acting, which is a blend of the two. And yeah, just kind of doing both for I'd say about 12 years. And then
Yeah, it's just been kind of like a gradual progression. And like we were talking about like beforehand, before he jumped on, it's just, yeah, looking at some of the projects that you've gotten to work on, I was just like, holy crap, like what got quite a list of different films and television that you've been part of. Supernatural, saw The Last of Us on there, different Hallmark films and stuff like that. So it's like, yeah, quite the impressive resume. And then now we got Long Legs, and I'm sure it's just gonna continue to grow from here. So
And that's the good thing about Vancouver, because that's where I'm located, is that we get a lot of larger film productions that come here from mostly from the States. So to step foot on set, it's amazing the opportunity that we have. Like we had all the CW shows, so like Arrow, Flash, Supergirl, Legends, all those shows, Supernatural. So to be on those shows right out of the gate, it's amazing. It's great. And then yes, we do a lot of Hallmarks out here. So that's a completely different film industry in itself, different style. It's great. It's fun. I worked on numerous Hallmarks, loved it. Started my career doing Hallmarks. Yes, it's kind of cool having high level productions come to your town, and you have the opportunity to work on them. It's great.
And so many various types of productions too. It's not necessarily just like one genre or anything like that. Like superheroes, you got that the horror stuff, you got Hallmark. So it's nice that you kind of get like the opportunity to do a bunch of different things.
Yeah, it comes in waves actually. Like we had like a wave of all the CW action hero shows were here for like literally like 8 years. They went away, and then we had a bunch of vampire stuff that came. It was a wave, you know what I mean? Like we had, what was it? Twilight, and then we had the other shows here that were all vampire, then they went away, and then we actually had a whole bunch of horrors that kind of came through here, thriller horror. It's interesting. It comes in, it's like everything. It's what else.
I was saying, yeah, it's interesting how that works. And so, we were already kind of talking a little bit about Long Legs, which is in theaters now, and you play Mother Camera on the film. What was your reaction to the script, like when you first came across the project? And can you just talk about like what your audition was like for the film, like as well?
Yeah, so my audition, I didn't have any dialogue, but I just let the camera run, and it was very specific about what they were looking for. So there was a breakdown. I wasn't just like, all right, let it roll. But it was basically the poster that I'm on where I have the knife in my hand. That whole scene mixed with another scene that wasn't in it was actually my audition scene.
Okay.
And so I put that in, sent it off. Didn't really think anything of it, as you do as an actor. You just kind of boop, all right, done. But when I read the script, I'm trying to piece it together how they're going to film it. It's a habit I do. I think a lot of us do that. You're reading it how you would kind of do it. So I'm reading. I'm like, okay, this is really interesting. This is different. Long legs, and they're giving the description of him, of Nick's character. So I'm building it in my head. Cut to, I book the role. I'm on set, and I see the house, and I'm putting everything together, the costume, and I'm trying to piece it together. I'm like, okay, this is the style that Oz is doing. Okay, interesting. And he shot half, mostly digital, half film. So I'm trying to like piece, like, okay, this is the flashback. This is what I'm in this. Okay, great. And I also doubled Micah. So I was also on set in other parts of the film where I was not acting in it. So I was doubling her driving and a bunch of other things. So I'm trying to piece it together. Okay, this is this. And then cut to, I'm watching the film and I'm like, oh, okay. This is Oz's eye. Okay. This is it. Interesting. So you're trying to like build a story in your head of what it's going to be. But I love it's kind of like, reading a book and then watching the movie. You have like nothing's going to top your imagination. But for this, I love that I was building it up in my head, but I was still so shocked and surprised, and just there was things that Oz put in the edit in the final version that weren't in this, like the snakes and people's and the sounds. There's
Oh
a
yeah,
bit
the
of
sound design was incredible.
description of that in the script, but he did him and the editor did an amazing job. And I was just trying to piece it all together, and I was so blown away. It was great. I love being blown away like that. It was awesome.
The sound design, yeah, was definitely like one of the highlights of the film. That just really kind of put you in that, that mood, and I thought that was really, really effective. Have you, like, prior to this, were you familiar, like, with any of Oz's work? Like, had you seen any of his other films or?
No, I did not work with him. I knew of his films prior. I did my research, but I did not work with him previously. I knew his like lineage, his family lineage in film and Hollywood for sure. But no, it was my first time working with him, and he was lovely. He was great. He was just like easy to kind of like shoot the shit with and just like bounce ideas off of. It was fun because just honestly, like kind of like what I said with my audition piece, he just let the camera roll and he was like, okay, I'm just gonna sit here and just give you maybe some tweaks here and there, but just go. And he just like kind of did one of these. And it was like so freeing and so fun. It was
I
great.
like
Rarely
going
happened.
into the movie, I didn't to a degree, I like had no idea what to expect just because the marketing was done so well, and like you said, it didn't give away a lot of what the film was about in the trailers, which I really loved as as a film fan. But I had seen one of his other previous films, The Black Coat's Daughter, several years ago, and that was a movie, one of those like slow burn type of horror films, and was a movie that really got under my skin. I love those like those slow burn type of horror films. For some reason, I don't know, those like just seem to like hit me more because I've seen so many horror films. It's kind of really hard to freak me out or scare me. But so I was like, all right, so he's the same director that did that. I'm expecting probably something, similar along those lines, especially where it's going to be in the horror thriller genre. And I mean, he didn't disappoint. It's definitely something that I've thought about, like, after seeing it the both times. So
It's great. And his jump scares are they're jump scares in a way that you wouldn't normally jump. And I don't want to give a spoiler, but I will say something. But it's when the detective is in the car and the mother comes around slowly.
yep.
Nothing's, but the audience, I knew it was going to happen because I'd seen it previously, but the audience literally, and nothing's happening really. Like, I don't say nothing's happening, but like, there's no gore, stabbing knife or anything like that. It's just somebody walks very slowly. And it's just like, oh, it's so uncomfortable. Or when he's looking in the mirror and he leans in, but he's not leaning in the way that you would assume with the way a mirror is positioned. That's brilliant. I
The way
love
that
it.
he lines up the shots too, like where a lot of, you guys would be like, or any other characters would be kind of in the center of the frame, and so you would have a lot of space on either side of the characters, and I just think the combination of everything in this film between, the music, the sound design, all of that, the lighting, you're
Yeah.
just sitting there as an audience member and you're looking on either side of the characters. Like at one point, Maiko was in like the house and you see like the kitchen door like behind her and you're just waiting for something to like
Know. It's a
pop out
tease.
there.
I know, right? How it the way she's framed and there's so much left over, you're like someone's going to come in, something's going to happen, but no. It's because you're on the edge of your seat waiting, 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 nothing. It's good. It's cool. Love
And
it.
I love that because just because you get those horror films where and everything has its place, but you get those horror films where it's like the typical jump scares, like you can see it a mile away because the sound drops out. So when you get something like this, it's amazing. And the second time that I saw it on Saturday night, that scene that you were talking about specifically, there were several people in the audience where, and I knew it was coming since I had saw it on Thursday, and that's kind of fun sometimes. But you saw, her come into frame and people were like, oh my God. And
I
just the
know.
reaction.
Isn't it fun seeing a film and then you go back, see it again, and hearing the audience when they have an emotion? I think I love that.
Oh yeah, I love it.
I love it because I know what's happening, and I'm just so curious. Are they gonna? Oh yeah, they're reacting. Okay, that's when I react. Okay. Oh, they're not reacting. Oh, it's just, I love that. I don't know. That's like the psychology of finding out audience members and when their, adrenal glands are spiking. But I think I love it. It's
I'm
great.
sure I can be probably a pain sometimes when I watch like films with my friends that I've maybe seen already. And like sometimes you just do the, you like look over to see, like, a scene's coming up and you look over to see if they react. And if they don't, you're like, why didn't you react? Like, what's your
I
problem?
know. I know. Yeah, it's
What are you
great.
doing? But yeah, so, and I mean, we're talking about, the atmosphere just that the film, creates, I thought was one of my favorite, parts of the film. Can you just compare that to what it was like to actually being on set and filming the movie? Did you guys have to kind of stop and make things a little bit lighter at times, just where it's such a dark film that you were, making?
No, I wish it was like that. Just because story of that sounds cool. But the scene where, oh, I'm giving it away if somebody's
Spoilers.
watching this, seen it, I'm sorry. But the scene with the axe and me, we actually shot that. So Fraser Corbett was our stunt coordinator. And originally that was supposed to be a one-er shot, meaning it's all one, it's not cut, it's not broken, anything. So there's a lot of technical pieces and elements that have to go together seamlessly. So we had where the doll was, the doll's face staring at me. So I come up to the face. That doll was obviously the camera lens. And right behind the camera lens, there's like nine people. Like you can't see it, but there's about nine people. There's a special effects guy down below. He's got like a thing of blood blasting on me. He's got a hook that's like hooking onto the back of me because they have an axe that comes in, has to clip onto a magnet, I believe we had at the time. And then we had a shackle that went onto the back of the harness that we had to clip on. So what happens is he's supposed to come behind, hit me, and then drag me all the way out. But the scene starts with the priest coming in. Charles Drummond comes in the door, looks down the hall, goes back. Then the father comes in, hits the priest, comes back. I come in, look at the doll. Father comes behind, hits me. I reach up to like grab the doll kind of thing, but he drags me all the way across. And so we had like a big pile of blood all the way across, like just a massive amount of blood. Just, and we're just like, more blood, bring in more blood.
I love it.
But it's kind of cool. But during the edit, obviously things go a little bit different, like they change it, they cut it up. Trying to just show like a small, flashback snippet of it. But we originally did shoot it as a one-er. And on the day, we're just trying to like hit all the beats because it is a one-er. So you have to like, by the time you come over here, you have to clip it. There's, Fraser's down below. He's trying to, get the latch on the one piece of the shackle, trying to hook it in, tie it in, so then it's locked in. So then he can drag me, so I can go with the axe. So it's all these beats, right? So it's not so, like, if it's dark and do we have to pause? It's more like, no, this is technical. We gotta nail this. We have to
Nail
like,
it in one take.
Execute this, otherwise it's not gonna look the way that we're look having it to look. So it was fun. It was a fun one to shoot. My God. It's a good
Man.
challenge. We always love challenges,
I'm so
overcome.
torn like now too, now that you mentioned that how it was like originally shot, because in the film, we see you get hit, the hand go up, but then it kind of cuts like right there. So we don't really see like you get like dragged. And I'm like, Would I have, would that have, I don't know, would I have liked to see that like happen, or does it work better with
I
it
think
just
it
being
works. I
under
think it works better the way it is, honestly, because
the
I
imagination?
don't think you need it. I don't think you
No.
need the rest of the drag. I think the way he edited it and cut it per, you know, it's it makes sense. You don't need to add any more. I don't know. He did a great job,
Yeah.
you know, even with his director's cut. I don't know what his director's cut was. I just know the last cut that we all saw,
Yeah.
but
No,
I like it.
I think I agree with you though too, just because it leaves more to the mind, and so you can just imagine like how the rest of that, you know, moment
Yes.
played out. So, and
Exactly.
with his style of directing, and just like I said, with like watching like the Black Coat's Daughter, I think that kind of fits in with what he's done previously. He's not necessarily someone with just like throwing, like he certainly has gore in his films, but it's not just like there for like gore, you know, gore's sake. Leaves a
Yeah.
little bit to the imagination, which freaks me out a little bit more sometimes. So I appreciated that.
Yeah, I do too, because I don't know, the gore stuff is fun and all for one, two, three scenes, maybe. And then after that, it's like, okay, it's repetitive. Okay. You know
Yeah.
what I mean? It gets to be, but if you have like one good one in a film and it
Yeah.
gets, you know what I mean? You're like, oh, I feel like sometimes less is more. You don't
Yep.
need fun.
No, I agree with you definitely, like on there. Yeah, I mean, so, and I saw that, we kind of talked about this too, that so you were a stunt double for Alicia back on Supernatural, and then you mentioned that you actually got to work with her again on a Hallmark film, which I thought, now think like thinking of watching this film, that I think that's just kind of like hilarious, like the contrast in that.
So
What was it like just getting to reconnect with her on Long Legs, you know, after working with her on those two previous projects?
yeah, it was great. Honestly, we were just, you know, joking around. She had her little dog with her in the trailer, so we're just laughing about old times and just especially on the this one Hallmark we worked with on a glacier. We had some stories about that one. That was a fun one. But yeah, it was really nice to just reconnect again. You know, she doesn't live up here, so she comes up obviously works, so I don't see her that often. But yeah, it was great. And she's lovely. She's a beautiful voice. She's also a singer, so sometimes she'll just break out in tune in the trailer. And she's just a gem of a human overall. Yeah, really
She
like
was
working.
almost like unrecognizable. Like I knew she was in the film, but like when she finally shows up, I don't know, I just like it didn't put it together in my head right away. Just like when you first get introduced to her, and even just the rest of the film, it's like, yeah, that's Alicia Witt. Like
I know.
a lot of people, you know,
Everything. It really transformed her. She's got stunning hair to begin with, like nice bright red hair. And then they put
yep.
this somber pulled down wig on her, no makeup kind of look, very homely, ill almost,
Yeah.
slate looking dementia, unfortunately. That's the word I'm going to use.
Yeah.
Just kind of lost a little bit. She crushed it. She did such a phenomenal job portraying, you know, that mom in that state. I loved it. I was really like, oh my God, it's
Yeah, and I
crazy.
think a lot of people, like obviously, like, you know, Nick Cage and Micah are getting, you know, a lot of praise, which they should, you know, both, you know, incredible performances. But yeah, I mean, Alicia right up there too. I mean, honestly, like the whole cast. I mean, Blair was amazing, like as well. All you guys just crushed it, like in each individual role. But she, yeah, she was
She's a
really
powerhouse.
creepy.
Yeah, she's a powerhouse. There was a scene, you know, with the doll in the backyard.
Yep.
That was an intense day, actually, like emotionally, just watching that, you know, that was a lot. There was a lot going on there, and it was really cool to be a part of that and watch that and just listen to the notes that Oz was giving. It was that day was that was a lot. That's all I'll say.
Okay. Yeah, no, and as far as, because I know you had mentioned too, you got to do some doubling for Micah as well, which I definitely want to ask you about that. Because I actually didn't know that initially going into this, so that's pretty cool. Because it's crazy, because I first discovered her about like 10 years ago with It Follows,
Yeah,
and
that was a
so
great.
yeah, that's like one of my favorite horror, like modern like horror films. And now that we're getting They Follows, I think is like the
I believe
title of the
it is they follow
sequel.
us. Yes, correct.
But so just getting to be back in a theater, because I vividly remember seeing It Follows in a theater. It was like this old theater that's by my house, and so getting to be back in a theater for almost like 10 years later and getting to see another horror film with her in it. What can you just talk a little bit about, you know, what it was like to work with her on the film as well?
Yeah, she was lovely. She was focused, obviously. She was, you know, the lead of this film, so she was very focused, but she was so lovely to work with. We were driving this piece of crap car, just kind of making fun of it, but also loving it at the same time. So, I don't know. She was just really focused. She kind of came from a sporty background too, so we kind of bonded over that. She came from,
Oh,
I
that's
believe,
cool.
surfing, wake surfing, kite surfing, and some other another water sport. But we were just talking about like the love of water. You know, I'm a diver in the ocean. She's a big water kid too, so we're just kind of, chatting about that. But she's a, I think she's like a crazy young powerhouse, and she's gonna just blow Hollywood apart, honestly. She's really making a way
Yeah, I
for
loved
herself
her
and for
performance
herself.
in here too. Just the uncomfortableness of her character, specifically one of the scenes, which is like one of the few
I know
like
what you're gonna
funny
say.
moments where she's in the bedroom,
On the bedroom with the daughter.
and
It's
just like
funny.
the interaction between those two. That was like one of the rare moments, like I said, that was like actually like funny. Where otherwise, it's a pretty creepy and serious film. But yeah, I love that little moment right there.
Yeah, it was great. It was just the way that they cut too. It's just like a wide, and
Yes.
she's sitting there just like awkwardly, like, just this is not my comfort zone.
The little line where she says like, "Oh, what happened to the head?" And then she says, she's like, "Oh, I guess that's more along the lines of like my kind of joke or something like that." That dark humor.
Absolutely. Loved it. It was so good.
So great. I'm curious for you, what was your reaction when you first saw Nick Cage as Long Legs?
When I saw him on screen, it was funny because, well, I'll tell you my husband's story. So we went to the film, we went to a private screening here in Vancouver with cast and crew only. Oz was hosting it. And my husband turns to me after and he goes, "I thought Nick Cage was in this." Didn't even really realize I was him. I was like, "Are you serious?" So the makeup team did a great job.
Oh,
He's like,
yeah.
"I can't even tell it's him." But it was really cool to see the wardrobe, the makeup, the hair, everything kind of come together and shape this character that was just so haunting. And just he was almost like a like you know the like the likable villain, but he was almost a likable villain in a way because you felt bad for him in certain moments of the film.
Yeah.
Like there was like the odd time where you showed a little bit of sympathy. And I think he just crushed it. I think Nick like literally did a phenomenal job. But seeing him on set, I personally didn't get to work with him on set. I didn't have any scenes with him. I wasn't there doubling mic
Oh,
on the day because
dang.
I didn't get to see him. But I just saw like a quick flash of him doing a test, like a wardrobe fitting or whatever test. And yeah, it's kind of cool to see, like the whole costume for like a blip of time. But yeah, putting all the pieces together on screen, it looked phenomenal. It looked so haunting. The whole white look. Oh God.
It's tough to strike that balance too, like you said, where it's like you can kind of feel bad for him in like certain moments, but at the same time you're also terrified of him as well. That's a very, hard
Fine
balance
line
to strike
gray.
there.
Yes.
He definitely, I mean, because it's like the film definitely getting comparisons to like, Silence of the Lambs, Sevens and stuff like that. He gave me Buffalo Bill vibes, like for sure, to a degree. But same thing, like even obviously knew that he was in the film, and you never really get to see him in any of the trailers. I think like at one point maybe they showed the scene where it's like
Like these ones.
you see that, and then they also show like the scene where it's like you just see like his jaw down.
Oh, the framing of that is brilliant. I love that. Where he like lowers down and it's only like to here. Love it.
Yeah,
It's
the
so
opening
smart.
of the film, it was just like, what a way to start things off. But kind of the same thing. Like I knew he was in there, but when you actually see him for the first time, I was like, if I didn't know this, I probably wouldn't have realized that was Nick Cage just because of the phenomenal job that they did with the hair and makeup and everything.
He was transformed like that. It was amazing. That's a
Yep.
good thing that they, I'm still thinking about it. It was just the prosthetics alone, the nose, the jaw, the cheekbones that they put on.
Yep.
It was just brilliant.
No, it's
Okay.
definitely, I'm sure it's probably given some people, nightmares, like after seeing,
Yeah.
this weekend, because yeah, such a great performance, and I think that one that'll be, remembered for years to come when
I
people
hope.
bring up, class
Definitely.
like horror villains and stuff like that. I think it'll be talked
Definitely.
about. You've talked a little bit about like working with him like already, but Oz Perkins, he's created a couple of like different horror films. Like I said, The Black Coat's Daughter, Long Legs now. What was it like working with him, and just what makes him stand out as a director for you? Because you've gotten to work with, so many directors already.
What stood out was he took his time. He wasn't rushed. This was an art for him. There was no studio chipping away to show, like, hey, we got to go, time, we got to go. Like, he really just took his time. You could tell he had a passion for this. This wasn't just like a job. Like, he eats, sleeps, breathes film. Like, you can tell there's like a little bit of a difference in some people. He really has that. Sorry, there's a beeping happening outside.
Oh no, you're
It's
good.
like crazy construction right now. It's the classic summer construction. Anyways, it was really freeing to work with him because he literally, like I said, just let the camera roll and he's like, yeah, just do your thing. And I was like, oh my God, you rarely get that. It's just an opportunity that's just like never happens almost. So it was really nice to collaborate with him in that way and just have him sit there and just kind of give notes. And he's really up to suggestions. A lot of people, I don't want to say a lot of people, but there's some directors that are just like, no, I already have, the storyboard. I have this. I know what I want to do. He's just like, yeah, sure. Okay. What do you got? Okay, great. And he just talks to you about it, which, is it's a dream. Everybody loves to work with a director like that, who's just also open and freeing and just let the ideas run.
Which I think, like a lot of times too, when you have people like that that are just willing to hear ideas, what other people might bring to the table, it's like sometimes you might have those happy, I don't say like happy accidents, but just different things that maybe you wouldn't have thought of, but kind of, and then it ends up working that like something that that person brought. It's like that works incredible for the scene, and that wouldn't have happened if you were like, nope, like we just have, we're doing it my way, and that's the final way that we're gonna do it.
Yeah,
So I
but
think that.
he was very specific about what he wanted, but at the same time, when you got to work, he was very open, like freeing and open, like, you do you. I know what I want. It's right here. This is the path. But within that, I want to let you kind of just be the artist. And it
Play
was
around,
like,
yeah.
God, I love this. Yeah. So I'll work with him any day. Yeah, it
Yeah,
was
I'll
great.
say hopefully you get to the opportunity to work with them again, and you've gotten to work. So I was like, going through your IMDb, you've gotten to work with another one of my other like favorite horror filmmakers working right now, and that's Mike Flanagan.
Oh, Mike. He's great. Yeah, he's crushing it, Mike.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing that he's put out that it's like that I haven't been a fan of. He's one of my favorite directors working today. Can you, going a little bit off of like Long Legs, but can you just talk about working like with him? And is there anything that him and Oz maybe share where they're both, great like horror directors, or if not, like what makes them different?
Well, they're in two different sectors. Like, one's television, one's film. I'm no expert, but I know for filming wise, there's sometimes a little bit more challenges with TV, with timeline, script, people, cast, studio. Like, it's more of a go, go, go. Or film, I think you can kind of like take your time a little bit more. But they're both brilliant in their own ways, but very different styles, I got to work with Mike and actually his wife Kate, on the first series that came here. And then they did oh God, they did Blind Manor, they
Oh, the
did
fall of the House of Usher,
House
right?
of Usher. Oh yeah, there's like four of them that they did here. And they have he has like a bit of a consistency of how he shoots, time-wise, what he likes to be shot in a certain, frame. Stunt-wise, he's pretty open for that. But they're such different filmmakers, which is so cool to me. Like, nobody, even though they're in the same, horror thriller, they're so different. You know what I mean? Which I think is really, really cool. It's kind of like action. You might have two action people, but they just shoot in a very different, a different way. It's kind of, I loved working with Mike. He was lovely. I loved working with Kate, his wife. Kate actually made a film, her own film with Mike. Oh God, what was it called? Hush. That's a really, did you ever see Hush?
So Hush is one of the few that I have not had the chance to see. And like now, because I think I don't, it was on Netflix and I don't think it's
Was.
on.
I just bought it on, oh God. So Amazon. I bought it on something. Watched it or
Oh,
rented it. I rented it. I had access to it for something for like 24 hours or something.
yep.
Phenomenal. She wrote it. She was in it. Like she's a powerhouse too. Wait,
She's
oh my God.
amazing. I've gotten to meet both of them at it was a horror convention like a couple years ago. They had like
Okay.
several people from like the Flanniverse. They were there
Okay, yep.
and
Yep.
just yeah, such super nice and incredible people just from the you know the handful of minutes that I got to you know to talk to him. But yeah, and I love how he works with a lot of the same people from project to project as well.
Which I like. Yeah.
Yeah,
Yeah.
that can sit well, and you're one of them. I mean, you've gotten to work with them a couple times now, so.
Yeah. I would love to keep working with them down the road again. But yeah, they're the powerhouse of Vancouver for sure in the thriller horror TV sector for sure.
Yep, for sure. And then I mean he's got his like films too, like Doctor Sleep. That's another for me, Doctor Sleep, It Follows, The Witch, The Babadook. Those are like all up there for probably like some of my favorite like modern like horror films. Long Legs, adding that to the list, The Blackcoat's Daughter. So those are like just like top of my head thinking like real quick are probably like some of my favorite like modern like horror movies.
Yeah. Well, that's a good
But
look. I'll take it.
What was your reaction when you like found out that your character was going to be used for some of the promotional material, you know, for like one of the posters? I mean, that must have been really exciting for you.
Yeah, I didn't know. Honestly, I had a friend of mine reach out and she was like, "Hey, did you know you're like on the poster?" I was like, and I was in my head, I'm picturing, you know how sometimes they have like the title and then they have pictures of people or whatever on the, like a mixture of the cast. I was like
Yeah.
picturing like, I didn't realize it was like a still of me, long legs, you know what I mean? So I was like, oh damn, okay, all right, let's do this. So it's kind of cool. I had people message me and, be like, "Hey, is this you?" Because it kind of looks like me, kind of not really looks like me. But
Yeah.
yeah, it was really interesting to have that wave of text messages and private messages on Instagram. Be like, is this you?
Were you able to get like do you have like a print or anything like of it? Because I know
I
like they
would
have like the main
love a
poster, but
print. I'm trying to find a print, if possible, that's obviously like I can, it's not going to be all, what's it called? The boxes where it's like pixelated.
all pixelated.
From printing it out. But I would love like just like a small little guy like that,
Yeah.
something. So I got to figure something out. So
Just
yeah,
for a
we can,
keepsake.
yeah, why not? Be kind
Well,
of
hey,
cool.
if you know if anyone's out here watching this, you know, make sure let's get a print over, you know, to Lisa so that way she has it for
Yeah,
collecting.
exactly. That'd be kind of cool. It'd be kind of neat. It was funny because when we were at the premiere, there was a bunch of people had a bunch of posters, and they were waiting for Nick and Micah and Alicia and Blair to show up just to sign them. And it was kind of cool because this one person had like this big one, and it was actually of the background of yours, but the house. And the bottom was like another, or sorry, not on the bottom, on the back of it was the one of me. And I was like, oh, that's actually pretty
Oh,
cool.
that's really cool. I
He was
wonder.
like flipping it and getting people to sign like both sides. I was like,
Ah,
that's a
geez, man, I'm so jealous. That sounds like it would have been, you know, awesome to be like at the premiere. But yeah, what were you gonna say?
oh yeah, they were handing out discs, or not discs, small albums of the soundtrack with also additional sounds of like phone calls that Nick Cage, like just like the little, oh my, I was like, oh my God, it's brilliant, so good.
That's so cool. I mean, you say you're no stranger to horror genre, you know, now at this point. What keeps you know, coming back? Were you always kind of like a horror fan, or is that something that you've kind of grown to?
I think I just kind of like grew into it. I love being scared. I love sitting in a theater or even in my house, watching a film on a screen, feeling like I'm about to die, and then I can just turn it off and then still feel that way. I think it's, I love that. I love that. When you watch a drama or a comedy or whatever, you turn the TV off or you walk out of the theater and you're like, that's nice. Okay. Do you want to go grab a snack or something? Yeah, sure. And then you're kind of like taken away. You might still think about it, but I love the feeling that a horror thriller can make you really feel terrified. I think it's brilliant. I love that. I don't know if that's like weird psycho part of me, but I just think it's interesting. Like the
I'm right.
whole, connection, emotion, feeling in the brain. It's so cool to be literally on the edge of your seat, feeling like you're about to die or someone's about to murder you. And then you walk away and you're still feeling that, even though it's done, you know, it's not real. You know, it's fake. You know, it's a movie, but you still hold on to that feeling. I love
Yeah.
that. I love that feeling. But
Quiet
yeah,
recess.
I would love to keep working in thriller horror sector. It's fun.
I'm
It's
right
it.
there. I mean, I'm right there with you. So, I mean, if it's wrong, then I guess we're both, I guess maybe we're both just psycho to some degree. Yeah. But I mean, there's just so much that you can do with the horror genre, like specifically, that fear that you were talking about. But there's just so many different like subgenres and stuff that you can go to, the different ways of storytelling that I don't think you can necessarily do with some other genres in film. And that's probably why it's, my favorite genre, like overall, just being able to explore all those different things.
Yeah, it's really hard to make everybody laugh, to show up in seats and watch a comedy and have
Yeah.
everybody enjoy the same joke. It's also hard for everybody to be emotionally affected when they watch a drama, the loss of this person or this person. But it's, I don't want to say it's easier, but it's more successful to have a larger group of people feel scared and feel vulnerable, in the horror world.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Everyone's humor is a little bit different when it comes to trying to, watch a comedy, like Farley Brothers. It doesn't, resonate with everybody, but I love it. Not
Yeah.
everybody does it. But if you watch like a thriller or a horror, mostly horror, I think it's you're bound to affect more people,
Yeah.
say.
No, I agree with that. Yeah, I'll say like, 'cause like for me, for comedy, like I love like the American Pie films and stuff like that. And I know that's not
Just dumb
necessarily.
cheap. I love them. They're so great.
Yeah, and I know like, 'cause I have like some friends that aren't necessarily like the biggest fans of like those like comedies. They like, other stuff. So exactly what you're saying, it's like it's different for everybody. But horror, it's like, yeah, just something.
I
Yeah,
feel like
something
you can
about.
affect more people with horror.
Yep,
Yeah.
exactly. And yeah, I mean, just to kind of wrap things up for you, is there anything else that you would like to say about, like Long Legs, like overall? And
Go watch it. Also, I want to say, like, don't. I think some people think that it's going to be like the scariest film, gory. It's not that at all. It's not. It sits with you. It's more of a haunting film.
Yeah.
The relationships between certain people will emotionally affect you, and I just feel like, sometimes there's like a lot of hype on films, and like, oh, I heard it was this, and I think they have a story in their head built up of what it's going to be, but it's not, and then they go and they're like, oh, I'm disappointed. It's like,
Yeah.
just get out of your head. Just understand it's not one of these gory, scary films. It's scary in a different way.
Yeah.
By that I mean, like I said, like the relationships with certain people and just the sounds and the visuals are haunting.
Yeah.
That's
Yeah.
all I want. So go watch it. Go fill your boots, but go in it with a different intention versus, oh, it's gonna, it's like Jaws. It's gonna scare. It's not that kind of film. It's not that kind of film, but go see it. Go challenge yourself and go see it. That's all I want to say.
And yeah, just what else? And because we were talking about just like, your projects and stuff as far as like coming up. What can you, is there anything that you can talk about that's coming up, soon for you? And
Yes.
can people stay up to date for you or
For
stay up to date
sure.
with your projects?
Yes, I just finished filming season two of Billy the Kid. It just got fully released in June, so that was exciting. So we're just waiting here on season three of this of Billy, and what's going to happen with that. But yeah, people can watch it on MGM Plus. Yeah, there's season one and season two out. So go watch that. It's Billy the Kid.
And you're on, I know you're on like Instagram. Is there anywhere else as far as like social media, fans can stay up to date with your work, or is that pretty much the main place?
Instagram, baby, that's me. It's the only platform. Yeah, I can't do the TikTok. I gotta limit my brain cells to just one social.
I'm
What
right there. I'm right there with
Instagram
you.
is it? I do like Instagram. It's great. You can, put a little reel on, put a little video or a post or whatever, and then step aside and then go back, and I try and educate myself versus just doom scrolling. So, just endless scrolling. But
It's very easy to get trapped.
yeah, it is. But it's funny because I do use Instagram a lot. I love watching movie trailers and TV, little snippets of it. It's great for that. I love
Yeah,
it.
Instagram's definitely out of the social media. That's like my favorite, platform to use. So I'll make sure to put your handle down below in the description so people can give you a follow. And Lisa, I just want to say, yeah, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks, Matt.
As you can tell, I'm a big, film nerd, so just getting to hear all the behind the scenes of, particularly like this movie, but just your career in general was a blast. And you're welcome back anytime in the future.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. This was great. This is fun. Awesome. And I'm glad you're a huge, you're a big fan and you love horror. That's great. Hi, I'm Lisa Chandler. I play Mother Camera in the newly anticipated Long Legs film directed by Oz Perkins. And you are watching Pop Culture with Pat. You can also watch me in the new MGM Plus show, Billy the Kid, playing Susan McSween.